But as Wang Chuqin straightens out everything, he's got the serves in this best of seven to start it off. Love all.
One.
Nice parallel forehand to start.
And what a forehand it is. It'll be interesting to see if Liang Junqin can tame it. He's one of the best blockers, controllers near the table, Liang. So I'll be interested to see.
Still felt like an 80% out of Leinhardt.
It did.
Let Wang, not vertically.
Both matches today, the second point of the match, the player serving was warned about verticality on toss. And can you tell some of the viewers what the rules are about verticality?
Yeah, so it has to be visible. What is it, 30%? It has to be in line with complete verticality behind the baseline.
On verticality, the main point, what it was warned for, anything more than 30%, or 30 degrees rather, off of straight up is considered not okay. Liang Junqin on the scoreboard now. Ooh, double happiness, the table sponsor. Net and edge, that's what we call it when someone gets fortune in the same shot with a net and an edge. 1-2.
Nice from Wang Chuqin, because this serve makes Liang Junqin feel like he can flick, and then he goes right to the other side. That's the only real cost of doing a backhand flick from the forehand. It can be really, really difficult to get back to that space if it's exploited.
We will see that again. It's a game of positioning. Many sports at this level, it might appear to a viewer, oh, I can hit the ball that hard. Why are they spinning it? Why are they serving it slowly? Well, unlike in tennis where you serve directly over the net, in table tennis you have to serve down, so serving fast takes incredible control. In a different way, but control here. He leans him off balance. This is that we were talking about. Getting someone to sacrifice positioning, and rarely will you see Wang Chuqin in singles up on 1 foot for long.
You have to bait him. You have to play with a plan, with a purpose against Wang Chuqin. Because if he's in a position, it's so often curtains. The backhand of Wang's a little bit different from Liang's.
It's so often curtains?
Yeah. End of show.
Six.
Oh, got it. I like it. Hadn't heard that term before, learning a new slang.
Here we go.
Gen Beta?
I don't know what it is.
Me neither. They're being born at this moment. Six serving three. Good pressure. It took a lot of work to get this point from Wang Chuqin, but the scoreboard right now heavily favoring the fan favorite of the crowd, and only a narrow fan favorite according to worldtabletennis.com. Although the ticket holders here.
Audience, please, players are ready. Please turn off your flash.
Oh, that's what it was. All the fans protecting
three,
the players.
Seven.
Calling them out. I like it. Hold them accountable. Beautiful three, brace here. Eight. Blocks it right back, accelerating, just guiding the ball into the middle.
Just an armor of Wang Chuqin right here. Still only 23 years old.
Eight, four.
Same age as Shasha, yeah?
And that's right.
Pretty interesting to think that the players at the top of the food chain, people just tuning in now that aren't used to competitive table tennis, often ask, what is the optimal age? What is the prime, the peak performance age of an athlete in table tennis? China, as the most dominant nation, has two 23-year-olds who will be world number one on Tuesday.
9-4.
Usually you see it at, what, around 27, 28? For a Chinese player, the peak?
Well, in the men's game, that's what I see. In the women's game, it's tough to say. A lot of women retiring, I guess, Ding Ning at a young 31 years old. Oh, the chase. Liang Junqin finding that wide forehand corner. We see this against lefties. Can you talk to us about why that wide forehand is often exploited against lefties?
Well, I guess hitting the ball wide to any position is advantageous. It gets them out of position. But for as a right-hander, your longest length is cross table. So it's actually the easier length to play as Wang Qichen sets up 5 game points.
Yeah, a lot to talk about here. Wang Qichen looking to take back what was taken from him in their last encounter.
10-6.
But 1 game point saved. I do think a lot of lefties like to turn the backhand corner because, well, it's a different setup than right-handers are used to. So when they step around, it leaves that wide forehand a bit more available and open. Liang Jingqun still down 4 game points. And the quality here, Lionheart, Wang Qichen takes the first. The serve was immediately putting the advantage on Liang Jingqun's side as he got the hesitation from the baseline, but it still wasn't easy for him to really keep the advantage in this point.
Yeah, it was a half-long receive from Wang, who improvised well. Still took so much from Liang. Nice push there.
At the towel break, I know we've given a lot of conversation to the Olympic Games and the importance of what this means to the men as well. It's a big conversation I know a lot of fans have been having since the last Olympic cycle finished. Manages to lean the upper body out of the way. Wang Qichen just far enough to shut down the plan that Liang Jingqun has here in this race to the backhand corner.
Bit of a seatbelt shot, wasn't it, there from Wang Qichen?
Safe and secure in the point.
This serve, so suffocating. It's not nice, is it, as well as a right-hander against a lefty with these kind of serves. We see it with Lin Minru as well.
Yeah, we see a lot of those bottle challenge serves, the one that curves down the line into the backhand corner. Again, if you're curious where it gets its name, as Liang Jingqun steps in front once again. WTT had a challenge on social media. If you could serve the ball around a bottle down the line, put a water bottle on the opponent's side of the table, serve around it. Heavy push as well. Now, you and I have had a chance to see Liang Jingqun play some incredible table tennis. And for a guy who's as physically, well, impressive as he is, as present as he is at the table, he's got so much delicacy in his hand, control in the touch game.
Yeah, he has.
And just there, used it to generate a lot of backspin to shut down the big attack.
And pushing long, deep with backspin is such a difficult thing because it takes quite a lot of oomph with the wrist action to generate it. But that can be the very thing that sends it too far.
Yeah, varying amounts of underspin or backspin on the ball keep the opponent guessing.
5-2.
Interesting, not so many players have winning records against Wang Qichen in terms of his generation anyway, although Liang Jingqun's a generation in front.
Yeah. A few years older, isn't it? Dapong.
6.
Gets over that one there, exaggerates the movement. He is in a very confident mood, Liang Jingqun. I mean, taking down Hadamoto Ball and Lin Minru, they're three. The three biggest threats that we've seen to Team China in recent history.
4-6.
Wang Qichen here with a bit of swagger. Just glancing that one past, fading it, not showing where it was going to go, and Liang even appreciated that. Liang keeps this 2-point cushion here. Second tiebreak of the second game.
Towel breaks optional, allowed every 6 points, but I imagine we'll be seeing the towels used just about every time as Wang Chuqing checks his racket to make sure that there are no bubbles. Sometimes it's a question of the gluing. Players often put their rubber on, put on new sheets of rubber before every match at a major event.
7-5.
If you're newer to the sport, the rubber is replaceable, like restringing a tennis racket. When you lose the traction on your spinny rubbers, or any rubber isn't to the quality that you like, you can put on a new sheet.
7-6.
1 point game now. Yang Jingquan looking for different answers and spin variation in the short game.
It's reverse pendulum from Liang Jingquan. Well received. It's not a serve that you see Wang Chuqing do. He does the pendulum and the shovel, but the flick there from Wang coming under it with a Chiquita action, because the playing surface is in the way, makes the flick more possible against the backspin serve.
8-7.
But an underspin shot, or a push of different sorts, to put underspin on a flick at all is pretty unusual. We almost don't even think of it as a flick, since flicks or flips are typically more aggressive shots inside the table, so that's quite unusual. 1 point in front now after trailing by some.
8-0.
Level playing field here. A man who's been quite dominant in recent years, Wang Chuqing, looking to get a 2-0 lead against an opponent who's got a winning record against him. And with the quality of this opening attack, you can see immediately Liang Jingquan regretted where that serve ended up. Not a lot of wiggle room, but at this level, that's enough for Wang Chuqing to confidently stare down his opponent and keep his hand cool. And the timing out in front, the early backhand sets up 2 game points for the player in the lead. Wang Chuqing, Petra Serling, Liu Goliang, Alvin Tan, and Po Li San. Some VIPs who will be presenters later on at the awards ceremony today. Locals and non-locals. 2 players on the left side of the screen there. Some good mime and laughter from Petra Serling. She's got that acting skill in her. And inside the table, drags the ball. Has been quite a strong player internationally for some time, but one better right here, Wang Chuqing, to start off game 3.
Love one.
The starts have been fine for Liang Jingquan, it feels, but at least in last game. What do you think he's going to have to change out here?
I think he has to be way more aggressive. I think despite how good he is at blocking, he has to try and dominate, and he's finding it very difficult to do it with the backhand.
Interesting.
I feel as though he wants to try and hunt the forehand just a little bit more, because where he's taking the backhand on for, it's costing him positioning on the table quite often.
You feel that he's stepping over to the forehand with the backhand too much?
Yeah.
Interesting. In terms of putting on the pressure early, when we think of the most fast and aggressive players in the game, Felix Lebrun is one of them that comes to mind, but against Wang Chuqing, there's just a different level of opening shot quality and aggression. It's not easy. Of course, serve and receive are so crucial at this level for getting into the rally. Again, Hope, another nickname, Xu Tiao, meaning French fries. What comes up if you try to type in Chateau on Chinese internet? Did you mean French fries? So they made some creative fan art here.
2-3.
But I was going to say, the short part of the game, if you can't get a quality opening attack in against Wang Chuqing, you're quickly done for. And he's quick to put the pressure on you as well. And staying in the rally with a guy who's so aggressive and has such a powerful stroke, not easy. Look at this. Not even touched, and he was in position.
It's robotic. I mean, these top players, they've reached a level of technique where technique no longer even becomes a thing in their mind. It's pure instinct. It's more about the visualization of the shot.
Like actors, know your lines so well that you forget them and you live them. The difference in shots here, the trajectory. Three, this is why Wang Chuqin is so dangerous. High risk, low drives, and the An Jingkun with explosive power, but he just plays more of a spinny arcing game. And look at the side spin on that inside out forehand. Wang Chuqin fans, we see you. Can't miss you, really. Most of the stadium. It's the most noise I've heard out of Wang Chuqin in quite some time.
He was surprised by the side spin on this third ball receive.
Yeah, beautiful banana flick from inside the table as Liang Jingquan puts that pressure on. Level playing field here at 4 points each.
It's just amazing how unaffected, almost disinterested Wang Chuqin is against quality balls. That's the way it seems, of course. He's having to work his hardest to beat them, but just isn't ever fazed.
I think part of this is inspiration from Longe, Captain Long, Big Brother Long. Ma Long, that is. But also, when you're told, hey, sit the bench for 3 months for tossing your racket after Zhao Zihao beats you.
And that could have a bad effect, couldn't it?
It sure could. But I think you wouldn't show it, you wouldn't volunteer it to an official if you didn't think it would benefit you. He was obviously quite distracted by the bubble that he found in his rubber. Could have been a bit broken off inside.
5-7.
The equipment is incredible when you think about how hard these players are hitting the balls and how hard the balls are. That's why they select the best of the best. Just 2 points ago, the rally, he looks down. It's quite a, think about how good you have to be to recognize that one of probably, oh, I don't know, 300 pips might have gone a little awry under the surface of your racket. How good you have to be to know that there was something other than yourself that caused you to miss a shot. Liang Jingquan in front by three now, the spare racket in hand for Lionheart Wang Chuqin.
8-6.
Fans like it. Again, Wang Chuqin with the support of the fans. He was always fiery. Again, I think quite an emotional player, Wang Chuqin, before, but after his time off, came back, had a very different sort of game face. Soft block was quite impressive. Liang Jingquan, the backhand for me, when he can get Wang Chuqin in the backhand corner, has been very effective.
Yeah, as you said, the opening attack has to be quality. Then if Wang steps, that's when Liang can switch with this backhand so well.
Six of the last eight for Liang Jingquan, and a big point much needed after quite a momentum shift for the player who's fighting for survival. Of course, it is a best of seven. He could go down 0-3. He's done it against other players in the top 10 in the world and come back to win. Good change of pace here. It's a fine balance as Liang Jingquan earns himself three game points of when to play the spinny shots and how. So many factors to consider. Slow spin and then a full racket stroke drops the racket low.
10-8.
A triple look back at that one. Liang Jingquan, he couldn't believe his eyes.
I think it was the top edge of the backhand of Wang Chuqin.
That would make sense. Wang Chuqin fans in the front row there. Letting the world know, let's take a look one more time. Ben Yan, he raised his hand to acknowledge the fortune, Wang Chuqin. One game point saved, a little big head scratching moment. Think the hyphen would be between big and head in that phrase. Over the table as well, no timeout now, Liang Jingquan. Interesting, he's got the serve. Tricky times here in the Infinity Lounge. Some of the more privileged ticket holders here. Wang Chuqin taking his chances, stepping around, leaving that backhand corner so open. A little warning to play, sort of a mini timeout without calling it, still saving the timeout. And that is three game points in a row saved. Wang Chuqin sends it to deuce in game number three.
the minerals, the resolve here of the world number two. This push right into the crossover, the hip of Liang Jingquin.
Alternating serves now until one player has a 2-point lead to take the game. He's still in it. Oh, and it just comes down wide. That was some incredible recovery, even the second shot for Wang Chuqin. The lines in the rackets turn. Liang Jingquin's got the red out, the springy side of the racket, because he no longer needs spin the way he would with the forehand in the counter loop rally against Wang Chuqin. And now it's the fourth game point for Liang Jingquin.
Again, the push.
The long, surprising push has been quite a supporting cast member, filled with all sorts of stars in the banana flick and that dominant forehand stroke.
You saw aggressively, and Liang, frustrated that he's not able to make at least a third ball.
And now, after a second deuce, saving what, 4 game points? Wang Chuqin sitting on a game point of his own and a chance to go up 3-0.
You shall not pass, he says, and when the arm goes up, the fist is clenched. You know you've got your work cut out.
So 6 of the last 8 points for Wang Chuqin. And he does it with the backhand, a 3-0 lead.
Love all.
It was a man wallowing, knowing that he had an incredible opportunity to be down 1-2 and get some momentum back.
One love.
But taking the first point here, and what could be the final game of this final, the championship battle, Liang Jingquin having won the last 2 encounters. This is a guy who really wants to put his chips on the square when the square is worth $60,000 and 2,000 world ranking points. We haven't talked about the Olympic selection yet, but maybe on a towel break. There's a lot riding on this match. An unusual way to see a shot go at this level of play, unless it hits the edge of the racket or something else. Keep an eye on Liang Jingquin's racket. Looked like he caught the back of the table as he was coming in, slowing down the shot for a moment, messing up the contact. And a service gift. A lot of not so predictable outcomes here in the early part of the game.
Well, he went for the same position with the serve as what he's managed to do with the push.
Can't get much better than that, and the satisfying sound of a shoe sweeping the floor following that ripping forehand. It's everything table tennis players want to be, and just too fast to be grabbed by the racket hand. I guess, or the free hand for that matter, but again, the star power in that forehand down the line might be a little bit misleading. It's still a close game here. It's tough to come back from the disappointment that has you with your head between your knees for the better part of a 1-minute water break.
Yeah, knowing that you could be 2-1 right now, it's something that's a tough pill to swallow. Doing a decent job of controlling the point there, Liang Jingquin. But again, you can't build a house on sand. Not against Wang Chuqin, and it has to start with a strong opening attack. You can't begin with what we call a more passive stroke.
Yeah, I was thinking you could maybe build a house, but you probably couldn't afford insurance on it.
Yeah, well, they wouldn't insure you.
Right. 3 points apiece now.
3.
Ooh,
4.
A little bit of a pirate pose there from Lionheart. At the end, hand on hip. Looked like he was on the front deck.
And the engine Quinn is on the edge of the plank here. Wang's ordered him to walk it.
Five, 3.
Now for me, again, it's fun to talk about who China will select. There are 3 players that stand out for the team that should be playing: Wang Chuqin, Fan Zhendong, and Ma Long. Liang Jingquin, I would expect to see on the bench as the 4th.
Five,
but nothing is guaranteed. And much like in the women's singles event, there's Fan Zhendong, the current world number one, as he watches on. He's been out for quite some time. A lot of interesting stuff happening right now with him on Chinese social media. It's not easy being a massive celebrity, the amount of expectations that follow you. You take 3 hours to enjoy a break, an opportunity.
Five, four.
All the players do it. They all take a few hours, maybe just slightly more privately or in their rooms, so fans letting their voices be heard.
4-6.
But anyway, in terms of who will play singles, you would imagine Wang Qiqin and Fan Zhendong. But Fan Zhendong has been beaten his fair share in the last year and a half, last 2 years, more so than Ma Long.
Audience, please, players are ready. 4-6.
Patricia Liu is an outstanding umpire. And just deep, trying to keep him baseline. We've seen the leaps, the fact that he can chase down balls that look so far out of reach, Wang Qiqin, and that's part of the Lionheart nickname, this never-give-up attitude.
He's impressed me with how well he's lobbed here, Wang Qiqin. Don't think of him as someone who uses flair in the same way as, say, a Truls Morigard or a Gozi, for example, or even a Ma Long.
Yeah, lobbing doesn't seem to be part of his vocabulary. Anything he can attack, he typically does. And while that last point, the lob missed the table deep, it is where you want to lob the ball typically. There's Ma Long himself right next to Yu Ziyang, who's been a practice partner for him over the years. Ma Long, the captain, the dragon, the dictator, the only man in history to win two Olympic singles gold medals consecutively, or period for that matter.
7-6.
And he's the defending Olympic gold medalist. Had his opportunities in last game, and depending on the outcome of this match, we'll see how he feels about it. Strong combination, but with the arc, the spin, if you can make shots like this, taking the ball on the rise, it is really tough to rally with. Liang Jingquan playing the more secure shots with spin, and Wang Qiqin giving no chance for anything but reactionary shots and ball chasing.
Just dismissive, absolutely dismissive.
Seven, eight.
Much needed here after a timeout. It can feel rough, especially, think about it, 10-7 and 10-9, no timeout called, and eventually a game taken from a man with a big dream. Not big dream, but big fatty. The step around is tough to contain as Wang Qiqin turns the corner and ties it up.
Imagine knowing where a ball's going but still not be able to do anything about it. He read that, Liang, but it was just such a hard forehand.
Unfortunately, I don't have to imagine that. World's fastest serve and the flash. Speaking of speed, another flash. We're so excited to have newcomers get your tickets. Watching it live is a game changer. Fans travel around the world watching the WTT events wherever they go. And they keep coming in, the new customers.
9-8.
It's a nice quality, and that camera angle gave us a nice perspective to see how low the ball was. The lack of arc, or say the trajectory on this one, much lower. Liang Jingquan has learned his lesson. It's just not always easy because you don't have so many options against Wang Qiqin.
9-8.
3 game points wasn't enough. He's 1 point in front and 1 point away from 2 game points. The world, well, number 5 currently, Liang Jingquan. And now he's got 2 game points. Will it be enough this time around? No timeouts left.
Well, let's see. He's on the receive, and we know what Wang's been doing with his third ball kill time and time again. Will that last game be living in the memory of Liang Jingquan?
Let it set.
It's fun to put yourself in the shoes of these players in these moments and think, what would you be serving? How would you be receiving? Against two game points, it's Wang Chuqin. This point is unbelievable. Unbelievable. I think we both thought that this was over as soon as Liang Jingquan was forced to push it from the baseline.
How the hell did he get back out to the baseline to take these off the bounce? It looked like he was too close to the table to even have that possibility, Wang Chuqin.
When the tough gets going.
The going get tough. How many times have we said it?
But I said it completely wrong there, but either way, the point is understood. They are raising their level now. One more game point. And it's Liang Jingquan to secure a much-needed game. The match continues. It is not over yet. Back to start over at 0-0. A fresh start here in the fifth, leading 3-1. As wide as can be, side spin to get that ball, going off the side of the table. Looking as cool as possible, that finishing shot.
And done, the fangirls love it. I mean, how sexy was that from Wang Chuqin?
I think all the fans would be quite excited about table tennis after the quality of that point.
A crush in more ways than one. I mean, off the bounce, he's barely ever made an error in this match. And it's so difficult to time, to know exactly when to meet the ball and with what posture.
We're talking about Wang Chuqin, a man who's been able to play these dangerous, very high-risk shots with incredibly high percentages. The first three shots in this rally were the perfect example of what we were just talking about, and finally Liang Jingquan was able to get him one step behind the table, but still, Wang Chuqin, after the seatbelt shot and one more, puts a finishing forehand deep into the body on the backhand side. Interesting. From that position, actually, Liang Jingquan was in a decent spot to get a clean forehand.
A feisty choke from Wang Chuqin establishes a lead early on here.
Yeah, we haven't heard too much of the choking out of Wang Chuqin just yet. Same in games as in points. Wang Chuqin up 3-1. It'd be nice to have a timeout right now, but Liang Jingquan doesn't. Each player is allowed one timeout per match, which gives them up to 60 seconds with no coach on the bench to basically think to themselves, hydrate. And they can come back anytime they want before 60 seconds is up, but after that, they get called back. It took a lot. The first ball to the backhand of Wang Chuqin, he was still coming down, didn't get there as early as he would like. The service gift here.
Yeah, it's tough now. That's the last thing he will have wanted. Liang Jingquan, he's got another. He has tried to vary the service up. Will he do the pendulum here or the reverse? Should be the pendulum.
6-2.
You can see the pressure he feels to hit the corners early on here because of what we've seen.
Early on in this match for Liang Jingquan, the wide forehand corner had been very effective, but it's not so simple as just hitting it to the wide forehand corner. It's how you set it up and how you get the opponent off balance or out of position. The footwork and the parallel, the roar of Lionheart, the main man out here, delivering the thrills, and look at the scoreboard now.
I mean, he's got him in his jaws here. The backhand cross table's been was especially so effective for Liang, but Wang has been pinning the forehand to sort of say, good luck hitting my wide forehand from there.
That's the Wang Chuqin I know from before banning. but it's all fair. It's in celebration, nothing disrespectful about it, just passion. In the replay from the point before, as Liang Jingquan gets one on the scoreboard. I was going to say, the way Wang Chuqin was able to play the backhand, reaching across the body so far without losing positioning, that's really impressive. The quality in the shot, too.
3-8.
This might be one of his best performances in any finals, Wang Chuqin. I can barely fault him at all.
And no need with the performance, I think, the way things are looking, he'll get everything he's worked for, but Liang Jingquan's still fighting to change that outcome.
8-4.
A nice tight serve, gets a passive receive, the push. Again, if you're newer to table tennis, a push is an underspin shot from inside the table. Typically a shorter racket motion. If you ever meet a trash talker, that's the best shot to use, a heavy push. Most people that are talking trash don't know how to keep that out of the net. But right now, out of the second towel break, a 4-point lead for the man with the serves.
9.
And he extends it 2 points away. The type of padding he needs, when we talk about the back and forth for world number one, Wang Chuqin's already been there, but he's been in and out quite quickly. If he can win this here, this would be big. Would set him apart a little bit in front of Fan Zhendong, the current world number one. How on earth does he do this? To even get to these balls is crazy, but to play the quality of shot, he's like three people at once. And you might need to tighten your mechanical shoelaces there. On the run, the block right back to the corner, down the line, nearly goes over to the assistant umpire booth, and it is 6 championship points.
5-10.
One saved for Liang Jingquan. A long way to go. He's had his comebacks, Liang Jingquan. Hugo Calderano, Lin Shedong, a few top players he's come back from.
Yes. 10-6.
Two in a row here.
Timeout.
And a timeout called now for the only man with a timeout left. He does it with a slow backhand. Wang Chuqin on his back has finally gotten his revenge, and he levels the playing field. He cannot believe it. The world number one can rest for the briefest of moments, and the teeth come out.